to meet a
The Velvet Rope, out now.
Where does the Velvet Rope sort of, does this work as a metaphor in terms of velvet ropes we put up to shut people out, in terms of, you know,
shut people out, not letting people get to know us, not letting us get to know ourselves even. It's like your protective shield in a way, or what you think is your protective shield that really, really can hurt you.
Her most personal album yet, written and recorded during a period of self-acknowledged depression.
It's childhood, it's my teenage years, my adulthood, lots of things that I've just carried with myself, around with me, and I had my escapism so that I wouldn't feel that pain. It took six and a half months to make the album, when before Control took 2.5 months, RN took three, mm-hmm. Janet took 3.5. This took six and a half months because I had to take so many breaks. It was too much for me, and I'd had to leave, go away for a week, take a break, and then come back and continue. And there were times when I didn't think I was going to complete it. Mm-hmm. I really didn't. And I did, obviously. It was as if he had read my diary, my life story, and I was in tears because he hit it right on the nose, what I was feeling, what I was going through. No one told me to go there to meet him. Our paths just crossed. He was there holding my hand the entire time. He was by my side and sometimes pushing me when I was afraid, knowing that I needed to look around the corner, and he would give me that shove. I'm a lot happier now. I'm still going through it. It's so much easier for me now that I understand it a lot more. But I still have my days where I, you know, have a little setback. Now I can understand where it's coming from and why it's happening. And it makes it a lot easier to deal with, and knowing that tomorrow is another day, is a new day.
I've been saying this on every interview. Janet Jackson, Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis need to get up off a track. Throw a brother a track or something. You know I'm gonna get in the studio with Janet. Y'all been producing her for like 5 years. Can I get some light? Y'all produce Mary J. Blige. Can I produce Janet, Jimmy, Terry?
Puffy campaigned, but when the Velvet Rope arrived, he was still on the outside looking in.
I've worked with everybody I wanted to work with.
Really?
Yeah.
Because there was one artist you'd mentioned before.
Yeah, there was one artist, yeah. I mentioned before.
All right.
But I mentioned her name, and she didn't want to work with me. She ain't want none of the hits. So I got to move on.
But it's like the album is done.
Yeah.
Not that he's begging, but I do hear he keeps,
yeah.
And he has asked me a few times. I don't know if it ever will happen. Maybe in the future, I don't know. I'm probably the only one who hasn't worked with him. Uh-huh.
Everybody has their own decisions they have to make. Like I love, you know, Janet Jackson's music. You know, I'm just mad that I couldn't have been on the album.
Uh-huh. Well, he knows he's got his pulse on what's happening right now, what the kids want to hear.
Mm-hmm.
He really does, and they're enjoying what he's given. So good for him.
I know you've said that some songs in particular were harder than others to get through. You'd be doing vocals and it was like you had to stop and come back to it. Mm-hmm. Any songs in particular?
Mm-hmm. You was one. I've been hearing on MTV that song is about my brother Michael.
People have taken it and said, well, she's talking about look in the mirror, my friend. And
well, see, that's it. I mean, is he the only man with a mirror? You is about me, which I always say I should have named it me, not you.
The whole rope thing takes a slightly different twist on a track like Rope Burn.
Well, I mean, there are certain things that I must say I do enjoy, but I'm not into this, beat me, pain.
Right. Just adventure. Life's an adventure.
I think there are certain things that could be very sexy.
Right.
in the way that they're done. And then you can also go too far, I feel. But that's just me. For someone else, that's perfect for them.
You got me on that damn speakerphone.
Yeah, I do.
What you doing with your hands that you can't pick up the phone?
Don't you worry about it. I'm taking care of my business.
If you do something like speakerphone, an interlude like speakerphone, you know that people are going to start speculating.
Yes, I do.
And that's cool?
Yes, and that's the reason why I did it, to get people to listen to themselves, to know that a lot of people have been asking, am I gay? So what is it? she likes girls or what? And the thing is, well, what does it matter? Is it going to change the way you view me? Which is a very sad thing.
Yeah, of course.
I'm still the same person, no different. What difference does it make? Well, I decided that I wanted to do a song about my friends. I wanted to do something that was uplifting, rejoiceful, that would reflect their personalities. I do believe that it doesn't just end here, that there's we go into another life, and that I will see them again. And we will be together, be there. That's basically pretty much it.
Party all over again.
You better believe it.
But that party version is only one of more than half a dozen incarnations of Together Again. As is commonly the practice with Janet's releases, remixes of the song were done, each geared toward a different market, from dance to urban radio to UK clubs.
Jimmy and I did two different mixes, totally different melodies. One is a little bit more sensual, the other one's more of a dance, but not house.
Yet it's the original Together Again Janet will be performing on her next world tour, complete with 8 dancers and an 8-piece band. As far as the set list goes, it's safe to say fans of her hits won't be disappointed.
You know what I did last time? There were things I cut out, like Control, Pleasure Principle, certain songs. Well, the first show that you came to, that was 2.5 hours long.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, okay. I remember singing Black Cat and thinking, oh my God, we're not even halfway finished with this show. Uh-huh. And I was like, okay, we have got to cut this down, which we did. But then kids would say, oh God, why didn't you do Pleasure Principle or Control? So I'm going to try and do every single. That's a goal I'm trying to set for myself.
So we're about to see the set for the new version, video version, Together.
Yeah, yes.
Tell me about this song and how this version came about.
And it's very sensual. I mean, it's a totally different feel.
Right.
Than the original.
Does it give Together Again a sad quality that maybe you didn't want it to have?
Yeah, it does give it that feeling, but for myself, that's okay, because what I wanted to accomplish was done. I dream about us together again. What I want is us together again, babe. To me, the feeling is, it's losing your lover. Like you've lost your lover, as opposed to your friends that have gone to another place. It's the loss of your lover. And there's a butterfly that's throughout the video that represents the spirit of my lover. What I give just to hold you close. In heaven we will be together. This is obviously the corridors. We're underneath you, so we'll get out of your way in a second. I like the ornateness, how ornate the door is. Very beautiful. Oh, this is more, I guess, like the living room area, I suppose, because there's the fireplace, unless it's the bedroom. And some of the angles that Renee's choosing, I think, are really cool. Very neat, very sensual.